Kandreva Khan on Reddit is asking, can the F-22 use the Amran in lock-on before launch mode? We are answering right now. Welcome to Millennium 7 Star, the channel that helps you make sense of military history and military technology. Our friend's question actually makes sense because on the F-22, the AMRAAMs are housed in a recessed bay under the plane. It is normally closed to preserve the stealth capacities, the stealth qualities of the plane, and it needs to be open and the missile ejected to be fired. So it actually makes sense to ask ourselves if the missile can acquire the target before the launch, because while the missile is inside the bay, most of its field of view is actually occluded. And the answer is, I have no idea. In the sense, I was unable to track a source that was actually mentioning this particular. If you know any F-22 pilot who is keen of talking about this and you can share, please let me know. Actually, add the line in the comments below or just add a comment already, wherever you like. That would be interesting to know from a knowledgeable source. However, a large part of the fun is actually making educated guesses. So let's try to have an educated guess. My educated guess is that no, lock-on before launch is not available on the F-22. The reason is exactly the one I was mentioning before. The weapon field of view is mostly occluded, and probably also switching on the radar inside the bay could actually interfere with other equipment. So I believe that the AMRAAM needs to be ejected from the bay with a conventional fire solution, and then it will acquire the target. Actually, the whole business of ejecting the missile from the base at very high speed or while the plane is maneuvering is an entire subject of its own, because the aerodynamic interaction are very peculiar, are very particular, so the technology required to do this is rather sophisticated. There is also another consideration to be made, is that this kind of use is probably fitting to the F-22 concept. The F-22 is supposed to operate like a hitman. So it operates to get relatively close to the target without being detected through its stealth features. Then take advantage of its weapons, firing what can be considered a surprise shot. So losing the lock-on before launch capacity is probably not a terrible loss in this context. Please also note that the small side window bays have the missile mounted on the mobile lid of the bay. So the missile, when the bay is open, is actually extracted. So the sensor has an unobstructed field of view. This was necessary because till very, very recently, the side windows was not supposed to be used in a lock-on after launch mode. So I'm sorry of not being able to answer the question directly, but I hope that this discussion is rather interesting and can be a spur to try to go deeper into this kind of subjects and try to understand better how technology works. So thank you for watching. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and hitting the bell so you won't miss any episode. If you like this short discussion, please hit like, otherwise, well, hit dislike. Anyway, as always, thank you for watching. Goodbye.